Okay, I'm back. And now, that don't worry, that's just Coral. Now I have something kind of cool that I want to show you guys. Super Mario 3 mix. I learned about this from some guy named Mike Matinee. And I thought it looked pretty cool, so I figured why the hell not? Let's do a little bit of it and see how it is. It's supposed to be one of the better Mario 3 ROM hacks. Sometimes it's a good idea for me to just do like a platformer. I enjoy those. And this has elements from various Mario games all mixed into one game using the Mario 3 engine. The first song I played was the Chocobo theme from Final Fantasy VII, or like the selected Chocobo theme. I don't know the name of the song. So, from what I understand, Luigi is, sadly, a carbon copy of Mario in this. So, sorry Luigi fans, there's not much of a difference. He doesn't jump higher, he doesn't really do a whole lot different. So this is, obviously, this is Mario 1, this stage. Oh shit. Someone said, the music isn't synced. That's not true, right? It's synced up. Or the sound isn't synced. That's a checkpoint, by the way. Mario 3 levels are notoriously very short, and there are no checkpoints in them. But this game incorporates slightly longer levels, and a checkpoint is then, I guess, kind of needed. There are 3 star coins per level that you have to find. So it's kind of like the new Super Mario Brothers games in that sense. It's a fake warp zone. Nice. Also, one of the problems I have with ROM hacks, usually they're way too hard. And I get kind of sick of that because I guess the people that make those games assume that experts are going to play them. I don't know. Because most ROM hacks I've played are frustratingly difficult. That's not the case all the time, but it's like that a lot. So I usually just don't do them. From what I've heard, this one is a bit more forgiving, closer to Nintendo standards of difficulty, which is to say, pretty easy in the beginning, and then it gets harder and harder, as opposed to just balls-to-the-wall difficult. So this music, some of you might recognize. Also, this slowdown, some of you guys might recognize, too. Super Mario Land 2. There are vines in this? Yep. Shit, Vine World. Oh, I didn't spend my Club Nintendo coins yet, because the site's been down. But I'm thinking about getting that Majora's Mask puzzle. The because the tote bag kind of looks a little bit assified, to be honest. The tote bag... Okay, so Club Nintendo has new physical rewards before they, you know, go under. And they have a Majora's Mask tote bag. It's black with Majora's Mask art on it, printed in black. I'm like, wait, what? You can't see the artwork because it's black on black. So I don't know if I'm going to get that. I might just get the puzzle. There's some good games on there, too. There's Kid Icarus and Wonderful 101's on there. A few other things that are kind of cool. So it's nice to see that Nintendo's actually putting some good rewards up. Fish level. Beware, this game does not save. I will definitely make sure that it does. If it means a save state, then that's what I'll do. Anyway, the checkpoints are actually kind of nice, because if the levels are going to be a bit longer, I would rather not have to start them from the beginning. I've always hated fish levels. Fucking jumping fish motherfuckers. Okay, we're good. My reaction when I heard Club Nintendo was being removed, I was kind of sad because, I don't know, I got some good stuff from Club Nintendo, like the Mario hat, I got a shirt from Club Nintendo, the Luigi's Mansion figure, a bunch of cool things actually, so I was, oh shit, Dry Bones looks a little weird. So yeah, I was a bit upset, but they're doing a new loyalty program after Club Nintendo shuts down. It would be nice if it was automatic, so like it just syncs to your account automatically, in which case I am very, very pleased about that, because having to enter the codes and answering surveys, it can be a little bit tedious. Sorry, tedious, no? Try harder next time. What is this? Oh, it's a door. Okay, so it's not... Oh shit, it's... Coop? It's an easy coop, but... It is Koop nonetheless. Oh shit, it's Mario 3 Koop, so he's coming down. How many fucking hits is- there you go. I just wanted to do that really bad. I could just easily just jump into the lava. After completing this level. Toad? Yes! Yes!
Thank you, hero! Our princess is in another castle!
See, that's what I would choose from Club Nintendo, a Toad bag. So, I'm enjoying this so far. I think it's... showing promise. Level design is nice. It feels pretty damn close to a Nintendo, like a Nintendo game, like the Lost Mario game. It's like Mario 3.5. Opinion on college. You've been thinking about dropping out. It seems kind of useless. Oh man, don't take my word for it. Ask LeVar Burton. I don't know. I mean, is college useless? I'm still paying off student loans. It didn't really help me get a job, but I'll tell you what, it helped a lot of my friends, the ones that do have jobs, You know, listen, if you're already at a certain point with college, don't drop out. Because then you just wasted money, and there's really, you know, no payoff. Stay in school, in this case. As much as I think college and student loans are a racket, if you've already put some time in, just stay in, make connections, get the most out of the programs they have available, go for a double major, whatever. Whatever can help. But yeah, it is a little bit rough these days to get a job anyway, so college is only going to help a little bit. But again, it will help, and that's important. Just don't do what I did. Don't go to a private college that costs $25,000 a year. Because that's what I did, because that's what my parents wanted. And I did it, and I'm grateful for the experience because I met a lot of good people, I made some connections, and I learned, I guess, a little bit. not a whole lot. Not any real life skills, but I learned a few things. It's funny, I remember taking a Photoshop class, and I was better at Photoshop than my teacher was. And I actually was able to teach some of the students a few things that the teacher was not able to. So people would come to me for help. Not trying to brag, just being honest. I loved Photoshop. And at the time, I was just really good at it. So I didn't really have that many classes that really did a whole lot. I actually went to I told you guys this. I went to a Catholic college. And, oh, fuck. Bye, mushroom. And I'm still learning about religion. Like, one class is science, and they're teaching me, like, this rational stuff. And then another class, they're telling me that a man survived inside of a whale's stomach for 3 days. And I'm just like, wait a minute, there's a discrepancy here. Higher learning? Slowdown is intense. Whoa, it went through! Remember the good old days of NES platforming, where you wanted to kill an enemy just to get rid of the slowdown? Do I recommend Catholic college? No. Not really. Go to a community college. If you can avoid debt, you're ahead of the game immediately, as soon as you get out of college. So I don't recommend Catholic. But if you're gonna do it anyway, because, I don't know, there's some kind of, like, vocation you're going for, or if the college is really good, you're getting a scholarship, then sure, do it. But if it's gonna break the bank, I wouldn't recommend it. The goal here is to avoid debt, not accrue debt. Do I like the Pokemans? I liked Pokemon X and Y. And before that, I had only played Pokemon Red. And Pokemon Snap a little bit. So, yeah, I would say I like them a little bit. I'm not, like, crazy about them, but the Pokemans are okay in my book. Vinny, have you ever thought of becoming an English teacher? No. I could do it. I think I could do it. I like teaching. Have I thought about doing it, though? Seriously? Probably not. So, if you guys remember, ghost houses were actually not in Super Mario Bros. 3. Sure, there were boos, but this whole theme is basically ripped from Super Mario World. And it looks pretty decent on the NES. You can see the technical limitations, but it doesn't look terrible. Even the music. There's some of those classic boos, but they're not the ones from Mario 3. They're like a weird amalgamation of the ones from Mario World. Oh, whoops. Thank you, Wilford. Appreciate it. What was the point of that? I like how the music is... there is an attempt made to emulate the Mario World music. It's a little derpy, but it's okay, I guess. I did not get the secret. You see that, though? I didn't get the secret exit for the Mushroom House. I gotta get the Mushroom House. So there's secret exits. So you can see the game has a lot of Mario World elements. It's kind of cool. I kind of like it. I always loved the ghost houses, but I've always hated how you had to replay them a few times if you fucked up the correct exit. You can control the coins in that last room. Oh, okay. That's right. Oh, okay. Yeah. I didn't expect that. I wonder how difficult it was, to translate a lot of this stuff into the NES architecture. Like, I'm wondering how much time was spent actually fucking painstakingly throwing, like, the P-switches and the controllable coin blocks. Shit. Yeah, you gotta really... You see what I mean? It's, like, kind of fucking annoying. No, I Am Null is finished. I am finished with I Am Null. Look at that. Fuck. There it is. There's the secret exit. So I'm curious about these fish. Alright. Never mind. Oh, it's a battle square. Okay, yeah, this was just like what Mike Matei put in the video. God damn it. So it's just defeat three fish. One, two, three. And you get a lovely little treasure. It really is like a Mario 3 sequel in some ways. Like a little love letter to Mario 3 fans. see some different suits here, guys. There's a carrot, and there's a penguin. Penguin. But yeah, there's a lot of, yeah, it's kind of cool. So this one's just keep going until you get two Bowsers. I got two mushrooms out of it. Love this music. Yeah. Yeah, this is bringing back some really good memories. I streamed Mario 3 last, after PAX last year. So sometime in April, I streamed Mario 3. I streamed it because I bought this book about Mario 3, which I have got, I got close to finishing it, but I never finished it. And, it was just about someone analyzing every single detail of level design, of the enemies, of the items, and why it's the greatest game ever made. So I read it, and it inspired me to, stream the game, and I did. So, about 8 or 9 months ago was the last time I played this. Shit. Ah, fuck. So I figured this will be something fun to play every now and then. You know, I haven't finished some of my other games I'm working on, but I think playing a game like this would be alright if I do, like, you know, one world at a time, just to throw in some variety during my streams. Because lately I've been playing a lot of, like, Far Cry and Grimrock and stuff that's not immediately accessible. At least I feel that way. So when I saw this from that matinee guy, I was like, oh, this is perfect. I haven't played a good platformer since last year, Donkey Kong Country Returns. Or Tropical Freeze, rather. Oh, there was Kirby last year, too. Darkest Dungeon. Do not tempt me. Do not tempt me. That game is finally out for you guys, and I cannot recommend it enough. I played a little bit on my own. I only did like one or two missions, but I did that yesterday. A few of my guys died, but I actually did complete a mission and level up one of my dudes too. So Darkest Dungeon is just amazing. What? Yoshi's New Island? What's that? I didn't play that. I like how I've only gotten a fire flower thus far. You know how in Mario World you only get the, Wait, no. Yeah. In Mario World, you only get the Fire Flower on the first world. And then the second world, Donut Plains, that's when you get the cape. So it, like, eases you into the game a little bit with one power-up. So obviously this game is trying to do that. Maybe, like, throw one power-up at you at a time. Who knows? Oh, I can pick these up. I can't throw them up? Not like puke them, but you know what I mean. Alright, I have a brilliant idea for a brand new Mario Brother character. Lackatoad. It's a toad in a cloud. And he throws screams at you in the form of compressed vibrations. Guys, when I last streamed Mario... my microphone, I think, is dying, everyone. Some bad things are happening. My microphone just lowered. I can't hear myself now. I wonder if it's this cable. Time to order a new $80 cable for this. Check, 1, 2. This happened earlier. This is why I was freaking out earlier. I have a compressor, so you probably won't notice the difference. You can hear me. I can't really hear myself, though. Which is a problem when you have headphones that are noise canceling. Check, 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 check. Jesus. Check, check, check. Okay, now it's better. I had to smack them. I was able to smack them and got results. Now I think it's actually probably the headphones and not the cable. These headphones were $250. AKG HSC 271, and they've been just slowly crapping out, whether it's the cable or, you know, when I dropped it on the floor. God damn it. I'll figure something out. Right now it works, and I do have a backup, but, you know, these are the best headphones I've ever owned, by far. It's just a shame that they're going so quickly. It's been... what did I do? God damn it. It's been about 2 years, almost. Yeah, it's been about 2 years, because if you listen to the Tingle streams... Those were 2 years ago, and I had my shitty microphone then that was, like, crapping out. Do I ever get nervous when I stream? Not anymore. I stream to over 1,000 people at a time. How many people here? We got 2,300 people. No, I don't get nervous because I feel like I'm just talking to my friends. Yeah, I mean, sometimes you worry about saying stupid shit, but doesn't anyone? Like, anytime? But I've streamed so many times in the thousands that at this point, I don't get nervous, no. However, if you put me on stage with a guitar and put me in front of people, I would get nervous. If I'm well practiced, the nervousness would probably only last like one or two songs, and then I get over it and I'm good. But, that initial kind of getting on stage moment is probably a little tough. For me, the internet, it's like, it's no problem. You know, that's easy. But if I have to actually be on stage, that's a little bit different. Is Super Mario 3D World good? Yes. I like that game. This is a long level, by the way. I think Bowie said, you know, he was finally comfortable on stage in his 40s. Imagine that. Like, the reason Bowie invented his characters, like Ziggy Stardust and the Thin White Duke, and all these, like, wacky characters, is because he was, like, really incredibly frightened of being on stage. And one of the things that helped him was becoming, like, a different person and just being in character. Because it wasn't him at that point. He could just play a part, play a role. And for the 70s, almost the entirety of the 70s, Bowie was in character in some way or another. And then when he hit 80s, he got a little bit more comfortable, but he was still doing some wackiness and whatever. Anyway, late 40s, early 50s, I think he said, was around the time when he felt like he could be himself and be comfortable on stage. John Lennon used to puke before he went on stage. I mean, then again, you're playing like Shea Stadium, you know what I mean? Doing all these huge gigs. It makes sense. What would a vine shroom do if it was in a Mario game? Some kind of corruption thing, maybe? Maybe it gives you a corruption of some sort. You shoot, like, glitch. You shoot glitches, and you glitch, like, blocks, and you can go through them. They would be rare, because you could break levels with them. What brand of that headset is yours? AKG HSC 271. But I have a very specific model of it, and they're expensive, and my warranty is more than likely up. Oh no, okay. I was fooled. It was a ruse. That wasn't actually the end of the level. Oh, look at this. If you waste your donuts, you might not be able to get back. God, now I want a donut. Great. So, I have a confession to make. The X-Files has changed me irreparably. I went food shopping today, and I bought sunflower seeds. Because I see Mulder with them a lot in the show. So I was like, yeah, I want to be like Mulder. He's cool. So I bought some sunflower seeds. There was ranch and original. I bought original. I'm not fucking around with ranch yet. I want to graduate to ranch. And they're kind of amazing. How far am I in X-Files? Like episode 6? Of season 6. Thank you, hero, but our princess is in another... eat me. The movie was pretty good. I'm pretty sure I saw the movie at some point when I was younger, but I don't remember. There's, like, moments in the there were moments in the movie that I was almost positive that I had seen when I was a kid. But, yeah, the show is really good. Season 6 starts out pretty strong. There's an episode with Nazis that I don't want to spoil. I really like that one. There's an episode with Michael McKean. Michael Keaton. How do you... Not Keaton. Who's the guy from Spinal Tap? Is it Michael McKean? Is that how you say it? Oh, fuck, I missed the thing. Oh, wait, I can get that. I really like that episode. I like how the show is not taking itself too seriously in season 6. There's an episode with Bruce Campbell. Yeah, Michael McKean. I really, really like him. There's an episode with Bruce Campbell, and it's a demonic episode. It is so fucking good. I love Bruce Campbell so much. Yeah, X-Files is on Netflix. Pizza, I recommend it. Just remember, season 1 and 2 are a little bit... they're good, but they start off a bit slow. And then it starts to just get better and better, I feel. And then worse and worse from what I've heard. After, like, season 7. And there are 9 seasons. But it's a good show. I don't think season 3 is really good, Jeff, but I think I like season 4 and 5 quite a bit. And 6 is starting out very, very well. For X-Files, someone just asked, when do you watch the movie? The movie, you gotta watch between 5 and 6. Between season 5 and 6. Am I going to Comic-Con this year? That's a long way off. I will be at New York Comic-Con this year. I try to go every year. New York Comic-Con is awesome. I'll also be at PAX. What music is this? Oh, fuck's sake. Slow down again. Oh, that was a trap pipe. Oh wait, no, we're still going. We're making progress. I have a confession to make. I hate levels like this, where you have to choose the right pipe. Clearly fucking this up a lot. So let's not do that anymore. Let's do this right. Eerio, super Eerio. It is this pipe up here. Alright, we got that one. Okay, so we're gonna go this way. No, I'm not doing Sonic 06. I get sent and requested to play a lot of really, really, really awful games, and not just awful games, but games I have absolutely no interest in. Like, damn it. It still says Game of Thrones? I was almost positive I updated that. Well, it's updated now, if it wasn't before. This is Game of Thrones, guys. I get sent games, like, not sent, but, like, people request me to play, like, 80-hour, 90-hour games. You know, like, they, like, there's a lot of really, like, Japanese games that people want me to play, like Japanese RPGs that I have no interest in. People say they're gonna send them to me sometimes. They're like, Vinny, I will send you this game so you can stream it. And I'm like, please don't. That's why I always ask that people actually send me a quick email first before they send me something. Because most of the time, I have so many other games I'm playing at the moment that there's not a chance in hell that I could get to it. I still haven't redeemed a number of Steam games that I do want to get to at some point. Like some really shitty funny ones. But, you know, only so many hours in a day. Just a second, guys. Yeah, that's why Marissa's here. Marissa will play the JRPGs. Could you imagine if I devoted all of my streaming time to the games that people sent me? Like 80 hours? Like, full 80-hour games? No way. I wouldn't be myself anymore. Okay, here we go. What kind of boss do we have here? Just another Koopa. Oh, he's throwing hammers, this fucker. Alright, well, I'll just abuse invincibility frames. Thank you. Peach has at last returned to our fair mushroom kingdom. Resting after their victorious defeat of Bowser, our heroes dream of a stairway leading to a world. Upon awakening, they went to a cave nearby, and in their surprise, they saw exactly what they had seen in their dreams. Some fucking new levels? Oh, shit. Hey, this is... That's kind of cool. Okay, so we got Mario 2 stuff going on now. That's awesome. You could even lift up the Shy Guys and throw them. Oh, I can swim. Oh, cool. Yeah, this is a really, really, really well done ROM hack. It's nice to revisit some of these old levels in the Mario 3 engine. You can't throw things up, though. You have to just throw them straight forward. Whoa. Okay, wait. Oh, right, there's the ninja. What do I think about the Nintendo YouTube thing? I think Nintendo's fucking stupid as hell. I think Nintendo needs to fucking get with the times and stop throwing away free promotion. Because they're just pissing people off. No YouTuber wants to have their fucking content owned by Nintendo. While Nintendo throws them like a morsel. And speaking from experience, when you upload a video on YouTube, the first 3 days are very, very important. That's when you get like a really, really good chunk of your views from subscribers, etc., etc. So Nintendo is what they're doing is they don't give you any money for 3 days. They keep all that. And then after 3 days, they'll throw you 60%. And they own your content. No, that's not good for free advertisement. So no, I don't plan on taking part in that program. And listen, I'll tell you from experience again, there are a lot of Nintendo games that have content claims on them. Probably will be this one. If you're watching this on Full Sauce, there's a good chance there's a content claim. Nintendo's gonna make all the money from it. Which is fine. You know, whatever. That's just how it's gotta be. They're not the only one. Sega did it with Bayonetta. Ubisoft does it. It's sadly something that happens quite a bit. But they're very, very strict about it. So no, I don't want Nintendo to own my videos. Yeah, we're gonna have to request that you take your video down because we don't like the content in it. We're hoping you could make this Tamodachi livestream more kid-friendly. Maybe Alpaca could just maybe have a handshake instead of have sex with Ralph. That's not to my liking. So yeah, I love Nintendo's games. They need to fucking get real. 5643, get real. You don't think they will with ROMs mods? Oh, they will. It's the music. See, YouTube does a music identification system. Mostly. They enter the music into the system, and through pattern recognition, the claim will be filed. Oh, that's not how you do that. So it's 100%, you know, this will be claimed, just based on the Mario 3 music. Now, whether or not Nintendo's actually going to go to individual YouTubers and say, hey, listen, can you change this? I doubt that, but it's a sobering thought, and it's one that kind of makes me not want to work with Nintendo, so. Nintendo-approved fun, TM. A lot of people are pissed about it. I'm less pissed because I am the type of person where something gets bought, like claimed, copyright claimed, I'm just like, whatever. You know what? I'm lucky enough as I am. I don't need the extra shekels. I'm just happy to do what I do and be able to stream. Most of the Full Sauce videos that are content claimed, we just leave them. And all that money goes to whoever. You know what I mean? Same thing with my videos on my channel. Oh God. Did they just turn into clouds? That's what I get for talking shit about Nintendo. Nintendo's mad they glitched my ROM hack. So yeah, like, I'll leave it. Most of the time I'll leave it, but there are some YouTubers that are severely pissed about this thing. And, I kinda get it. Like, I understand, though. And I'd prefer if the system wasn't like that. I think, in a perfect world for YouTubers, it would be this. And some people already have this in place, I think. YouTuber gets 50%. The content claim company gets 50% right off the bat. Or the person who spent hours and hours and hours editing this video should get like 70%, and then say Nintendo should get 30%, and that should just go into effect from day one. Both parties are happy, both parties make money, and there's no more bitching. And that's it. And then you're good. That's my opinion. Now that's what I feel about it, and I think that's the future of what's gonna happen. Shit. Google gets a portion too. Yeah, that's true. Can't forget about that. But, you know, it's whatever. It's a problem for people that make videos, but it's ultimately not a problem. I remember when you would get a copyright strike on your channel if you had music that was, like, claimed. At least they're not doing that. Like, that's a different level of awfulness. If you can no longer make videos because one of your games had, like, a song in it. Like, if I played GTA and Queen's Radio Gaga came on, made a YouTube video of that. Imagine that. And then I have a strike on my channel and I can't do what I need to do. That happened to me. I actually had a few strikes on my channel in the early days. I couldn't upload videos longer than 10 minutes. And it sucked. But that is over, luckily. So at the very least, some progress has been made. YouTube became too huge, just like Twitch did, which is why they VOD mute. It's not necessarily even YouTube or Google's fault, rather. It's not even really necessarily Twitch's fault. They got pressure from the record labels and the movie industry and other video game companies. And it's like, things are changing, guys. You know, the music industry in and of itself is dying a painful death right now. You know, they have to downgrade from 5 yachts to 1 because no one's buying CDs anymore. Because, well, not only are they expensive, but, you know, the band doesn't even get the money. The artist barely makes anything on a CD. You know, you have to, if you're a fucking musician, you gotta do shows if you wanna make money. It's not about selling records anymore. But the music industry got so incredibly greedy. Karma is hitting them hard right now. And there's still some of them, many of them, that are not adapting. They are desperately holding on to the old ways. Desperately trying to make those monies. And that's why we have this Twitch issue, where I can't play you like the Pixies while I'm doing a BRB. Because then it would get muted. Which sucks, because I would love to show you guys Pixies music, so some of you might go and fucking buy a Pixies album, but I can't do that. You know, or if I play, you know, Tame Impala. You know what? They're doing shows soon. Maybe if I played some Tame Impala songs during a BRB, people would be like, who's that? Oh, that's Tame Impala. Check them out. Go see a concert. Can't do that. Because it's copyright. So you can't give the artist that extra exposure. Because they're afraid people are going to pirate. No, they're going to do it anyway. Except now, less people are gonna find out who the fuck the bands are. But that's just my opinion. Me and Mike are... Well, the Pixies don't give a shit. They're the fucking... The Pixies from the 80s. They're making their money from shows anyway. Now that they're back together. Mike and I are thinking about doing something. You know, I want to record some songs. I don't want to necessarily be in a band, but I want to record some music. And if I do record some songs, I'm going to do it locally. I'm going to put up the money. I'm going to record them. And, you know, I'll just put them on Bandcamp and throw them on YouTube. And you know what? Free. You want them? They're free. Download them for free. Here's 12 songs. If you want to buy the album, you can spend $1 on it. You can spend $10 on it. If you want it for free, it's yours. I don't care. Or you can just go to YouTube and listen to it. That's the way it should be. Because if you're good enough as a musician, you should be able to just do what you do because you love doing it. And then a few people might help you out. You know, and then you do a show. People come see you and you make your money that way. You know, it's no longer the fucking Def Leppard days of driving a motorcycle through a hotel. You know what I mean? Like, now musicians have to live a bit more modestly. But that's what it's about, right? I mean, that's what music is about as far as I'm concerned. It's not about the money. I mean, unless you're talking to some of these rappers or even some of the fucking, you know, there's a lot of rock guys that are just all about the money. But, you know, the people that, like, big up themselves, fancy car, you know, I'm a star. Like, that's not what music is. Music is music. It's supposed to be shared. It's supposed to be listened to. It's there for you when you need something, when you're having a tough time, you know, when you have some problems in your life. You throw on a song, you throw on an album, it makes you feel good. You know, when you're having a good time with your friends, you throw on an album, it makes you feel good. That's what music is. It's to be shared. And if you're only making the music to become fucking super rich and live in a mansion, then you shouldn't be making music. You know, that's not the priority. That's not why I got into the musician game. I did it because I love playing guitar. I love writing songs. Blah, 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 blah. The point is, the music industry has to change. That's all I'm trying to say. And the smaller labels can make it happen if they just readjust their earnings. But right now, the big labels don't want to do that. They're still holding on, and those execs don't want to get rid of their yachts and mansions. So, as a result, Twitch has VOD muting, and YouTube has content claim, etc. So that's my opinion about all that. That's how I feel about all that. And I could be wrong. I just want you to know. I'm not claiming to be some kind of expert on the subject. Could be wrong in anything I say, really. Except that, you know, my eyes are green. I got that. That's a fact. But, you know, I'm sure there's some good record labels out there. Somewhere. Also, new Gorillaz. Gorillaz are back together, guys. That's pretty exciting. Clever level design in here, I have to say. I'm enjoying the different themes per level. I like how it reminds me of Mario 2. Without being a slave to Mario 2's gameplay. It's kind of good. And yes, this is a very long level so far, huh? Whoa, what the hell's going on? Some weird glitching. If any Gorillaz fans here are looking for some music to listen to while the Gorillaz are, while Damon's working on some new music, I recommend Blur. That's Damon's other band. You probably have heard of it. I also recommend The Good, The Bad, The Queen. That's another band that Damon fronted that has some Gorillaz vibes to it. And Damon Albarn's solo album. I mean, this is all stuff that has Damon in it, but otherwise listen to Beck. Maybe you might enjoy the album Güero and Odele. I think those two are really good Beck, like fun kind of Gorillaz-esque albums. Not really Gorillaz-esque, but they have the same kind of upbeat feel to them in a way, and there's like a bit of rock in there as well as some of the other stuff. Thank you. I don't know what the point of that was. Oh, that right there. Maybe that. God. As much as I like ghost houses, they piss me off. What's the most depressing and dour music you know? Wow, that is a question. Holy shit. Listen, there's a lot of depressing and dour music that I listen to. But the most depressing and dour is probably Elliott Smith, baby. Elliott Smith is definitely one of the most go-to guys for music that is super depressing. I fucked up again. I made the same mistake. I see what I have to do now, by the way. So yeah, old Nine Inch Nails. There you go. The Cure is a little bit depressing. I don't really listen to them though. Yeah, I definitely say like some Radiohead's pretty fucking like dark. But Elliott Smith is one of the most. I would give him the gold for that one. Yeah, Trent Reznor's. Well, he was a real depressed asshole back in the day. But he. I think he's not really quite as depressed anymore. The new Nine Inch Nails album was pretty good. It wasn't his best, but it was pretty. It's pretty enjoyable, I would say. Okay, now I can hit the thing. There you go. Tomorrow's Modern Boxes by Tom York. Yeah, that was a pretty fucking depressing album. I've listened to that a lot. For about a week, I listened to that, the full album on repeat, and it's very depressing sounding. I find a lot of depressing music, though. Like the sad songs. You know how, like, if you're a rock fan. Oh, fuck. If you're a rock fan, you might know that, like, some bands have just very depressing music. Like, one or two songs, just out of nowhere, will be, like, super, like, soul-crushing. God damn it. And, there is beauty to be found in the darkness. I hate to say it like that. That makes me sound kind of emo. But it's true. I've written some fucking dark, depressing music from time to time. I have a song that's like really, really just anger and like hatred filled. But you know, there's a time and place for it. And you know, you can't go through life, I don't think, just like with a fake smile plastered on your face all the time. Sometimes you actually have to feel a little shitty if you want to know what it feels like to be good. And you know, a little depressing music every now and then, it's fine by me. There's a song called King's Crossing by Elliott Smith. That is one of, I think, the most powerfully fucked up songs I've ever heard in my entire life. And it had its place in my life, I would say. For a song that depressing, I can't listen to it all the time. I do not put it on all the time. There are times when I avoid it because it's too heavy. But it's there when I need it, you know what I mean? Great, good job, Vin. Fall into a pit. Everyone's asking me about Monty. Thing is, I didn't know Monty's work. So I don't have much of an opinion on it, I'm sorry to say. Anytime someone passes in the video game community, especially if it's in the entertainment field, I get a little bit upset. And even if I don't know the guy, it's just sad. So I will say rest in peace, Monty. I wish I got to know your work before you passed. And I will probably end up doing a little research on him and finding out some of the stuff he's done in retrospect. God damn it! Oh, I'm doing terrible, guys. I'm too focused on talking, and it's like, I'm not able to kill. Hey Lloyd? Yeah, I've seen Hey Lloyd. Like I said, I've seen that recently. And I thought it was really good for its time. So that I'm aware of. And that is some really impressive shit. But I've only seen that in retrospect. David Gilmour can be pretty depressing. Yeah, there's some Floyd music that's like pretty... I would say Waters was the more depressing of the two. But the way Gilmour's guitar sounds, there's a song called Sorrow, for example. That one's pretty depressing sounding. There's some pretty dark Floyd songs. Good job, Vin. There's one. Okay, we're gonna do this time. I'm gonna focus, right? And I'm not gonna be yapping, because you can get me to talk. You put me on a topic I'm interested in, I will talk for hours. That's a dark song. That's a really dark Floyd song. I love that. Oh, Alice in Chains too. Yeah, that's another one. Holy shit. Jar of Flies in particular. But Dogs is great. I think Dogs is probably one of the best. It's so like... I think it's perfect. What do you want from me? Yeah, that's a good one, Altier. Good. I've opened the stream with that a few times because I may have felt that way a few times. That's a really good song. And that's late Floyd. That's like post Waters Floyd. But that's a good observation you made there. Ah, fuck, there's a pipe. Guys, I'm not going to be able to do the pipe. I'm just going to pass it because I don't care right now. Steve Wilson, yeah, I like Porcupine Tree. I might do just a few more levels. I wanted to do a little Darkest Dungeon tonight. Tomorrow, I will not be streaming my regular stuff. I have a guest joining me for a stream tomorrow. And, it should be interesting. So, I'm hoping Thursday, maybe, or maybe Friday, I'll try to finish Grimrock, or at least play it. I mean, I've got all these games that I haven't even really had a chance to get to yet. Yeah, I'm not going to do level 5 right now. I might do it after this level. I'm going to save. Oh, that's climbable. If that's supposed to be a door, I can't go through it. Yes, DJ Khaled will be here. He and I will be streaming together. it's no one huge. Listen, it's no one, you know, with like ton. It's a Vine Sauce friend, but it's not like anyone, you know, huge. I would love to have Critical on. I don't know how good Critical would be off the cuff, though. I wonder if he'd be down for a co-stream. I don't know if I have that kind of pull to just get Critical. You know, people are like, Vinny, you should get Critical for a guest stream. It's like, I've gotten in touch with the dude once through YouTube. I don't think he checks his messages anymore. His channel really blew up. But, there's probably a very, very high probability that it would be very difficult to get Critical on board for a guest stream or for a co-stream. Shit. I'm kidding, it's not DJ Khaled. Hope no one believed that. He still reads all of his messages. That's interesting. I mean, what could we do? Maybe some Smash Brothers or something, like I did with Kryken. Shit, Mauser. Oh. Shit, he jumps. Ah. There's one. There's two. Okay, cool. We're gonna save this here. I just did the save and continue. What's the Star Road option? Guys, there's an option for Star Road. Oh, this just takes you back to, oh, that's good. So you can go back and, if you need to get a star you missed, there it is. This is kind of cool too because it shows you how many worlds there are. So we know there's at least 8 and probably a hidden one in the middle someplace. So that's pretty cool. Southbird, huh? Well, it's good. I like this a lot. I think Southbird did a really, really good job. So, stick around for a few minutes. We'll do some Darkest Dungeon to close out the night. Maybe a half hour of that, 45 minutes of that, and then I will get going. I'll check the art and get going. So, I will see you guys in just a few minutes. And you can expect more Mario 3 mix over the next few weeks. It's good enough for me to keep coming back to it. So, I certainly will. See you soon.